Welcome to another unit of the ISM exercise set Statistics 2, this time with a unit on the coefficient of determination and the F-test. Let's have a look at the exercise. Five students are questioned in regard to the time they spent preparing for a language test. The following table summarizes the results of the test, here variable score, and the preparation time, here variable time. That's then the different outcomes for the five students. Our first task, calculate the coefficient of determination R squared, assuming that the regression line is or has the following form. And part B, perform a suitable test with a margin of error of 1% to test whether the relation described by the regression line is significant as well. So let's do both parts step by step. So first we want to get the coefficient of determination. For this we copy the regression line and then we copy the table we were given. Here we actually have two ways to go about this. As we only have one independent variable, we could calculate the Pearson correlation coefficient and then just square this. But this only works if we only have one independent variable. Here we're going with the more general approach. This means we add first one row where we calculate the y values being squared. So 101 being squared, 105 being squared, and so forth. Then we add a row where we square y hat variables. What's the y hat? The y hat is the variable or the value we get when we insert x into the regression line. So if here we insert 10, we have 0.7554 times 10 plus 94.3222. This result is then squared, giving us here y hat squared. So we're doing this. And then we're calculating for all four rows the averages, because that's the four values we're going to need next. Three values we need next, because the r squared is given as the average of y hat squared. So here it's the 11,103.39 minus the average of y squared, which is 105.2 squared. All of this is divided by y squared, thereof the average. So here the 11,104.8 minus again the average of y being squared. So again 105.2 squared. We enter this into the calculator. We get here an r squared of 0.9627. This means that 96.27% of the variance of the dependent variable, so here of the test score, can be explained via the regression line, so via the time spent preparing. Now we want to know whether this is actually a significant share, so if the model has significant explanatory power. This we're going to test via an F-test. For the F-test, first we get the F-statistic, the test statistic. This is given here as R squared divided by K, then all of this divided by 1 minus r squared divided by n minus k minus 1. The n here is the number of observations, that's 5, and the k is the number of independent variables. Well, only have one variable here, one independent, one x, so k is 1. With this information and the r squared of 0.9627, we can get an F statistic of 77.429. In addition to this test statistic, we also need a reference statistic, and the reference statistic here is given as F, K as the first degree of freedom, then N minus K minus 1, so here 5 minus 1 minus 1 as the second degree of freedom, and then 1 minus alpha, whereas here we know from the exercise text alpha has been set as 1%, That's the acceptable margin of error. So here we have alpha 1%, K1, N5. So we get, or we need, the F value for F130.99. If we look up this value in the table, we find there a value of 34.116. This value, this reference value or critical value, is then compared to the test statistic we calculated above. So here we get as a result that our test statistic is larger than the reference statistic, than the critical value. This means we can reject our H0 hypothesis, which in the case of the F test is that the model has no significant explanatory power. So here we know our model has significant explanatory power. And well, a different formulation for this would be H0 could be that all our parameters or all our coefficients are zero. So here we have shown that there's at least 99% chance that one of the parameters is different from zero. Okay, this is basically all we have to do in the course of this exercise. Well, I hope you enjoyed listening to it. And if you want to see more exercises, feel free to visit the rest of the exercise set or have a look in the corresponding playlist. I say goodbye and see you next time.